Congenital heart and vessel defects affect about 40,000 births every year in the United States. But what if that number could be lower, substantially lower? I am an expert in cardiovascular development, but my research really comes down to two short words. What if? If brings possibilities. It solves mysteries. It allows people to dream. It could also save lives. If we understand the rules of how blood vessels are created or how they work, we could potentially repair them in a child or adult, or even build them outside of the body. I can explain these rules using simple items you probably have around your house: a bottle of perfume, a roll of paper towels, and a garden hose. First, we must know how vessels around the heart become thicker, so they can carry more blood. Our hypothesis? High-flow vessels send out molecules in the tissue. Smooth muscle cells sense those molecules and move there. It's like entering a dark room where somebody opened a bottle of perfume. You'd probably be able to locate the source by smell alone. Then, those smooth muscle cells must attach to the vessel. It's like a paper towel roll. The cardboard tube is the inner lining of the vessel, while the paper towels are the extra layers of smooth muscle cells. But the missing question is, how do the high-flow vessels know they become surrounded with smooth muscle cells? The answer? Mechanical force. When you turn on the nozzle attached to a garden hose, the flowing water creates friction against the walls of the hose. Blood flow works the same way in the body, and that force can be sensed by the blood vessel tissue. Thanks to a substantial grant from the National Heart, Lung, and Blood Institute, I am able to conduct research alongside both undergraduate and graduate students. With this team, we're experimenting with embryos from several organisms, including zebrafish and mice. We have found that exposure to drugs and other substances, or physically altering blood flow, can change the cardiovascular development of these embryos. This provides important information about the genes, molecules, and forces required to build blood vessels, which ultimately can translate to human beings. Together, we are working to answer the question, what if?